What about when your Objective-C code is consuming Swift errors? Let's take a look at how a Swift method that throws would be interpreted by Objective-C. Here I have a project whose main function is in Objective-C. The project includes a Swift class with the following error-throwing function. This function throws an error of type myError. Notice that in order to expose this enum to Objective-C, I mark it with the attribute @obj_c. Now we're going to call this function from our main function. We've got a variable to hold our error and an instance of some Swift class. Now let's call our Swift function. Notice that Xcode gives us the option to call do something that might fail and return error. And return error has been appended to the method name, and now we have the option to pass an error parameter into the method. Cool. That's not that surprising. It's pretty much the reverse of what we saw going from Objective-C to Swift. Now let's see how the error might be processed. We'll write a log statement, and in that statement, we'll grab the domain and code from the error that's returned. And then if we run it, here's what we see in the console. So the domain and error code are automatically populated, which is super. Unfortunately, if you want to know the value of the enum member that goes with that code, like weird reason or typical reason that you can see here, you can't access it directly from your Objective-C code. You have to look back at the enum implementation. It was no coincidence that I wrote the myError enum to be of type int. Let's not forget that enums in Objective-C can only hold ints. That means that if you have a Swift error that you want to be consumed by Objective-C, it has to be of type int. Unfortunately, that means that enums like this one that provide information about the errors right in their raw values can't be translated to Objective-C. Even though NS errors aren't as spiffy as Swift errors, the takeaway here is that the interop for error handling is mostly handled for you. NS errors just work in Swift, and all you have to do to get your Swift errors to work in Objective-C is mark them with the attribute @obj_c and make sure they have an integer type.